New Hampshire hasn't been kind to Ben Carson or Carly Fiorina. Final tallies aren't in yet, but Carson and Fiorina are hovering near the very bottom of the GOP pack. Carson is performing the worst with just 2.3% of the vote to Fiorina's 4.4%. It's hard to see how either can remain a viable candidate for much longer, though so far nobody's dropped out tonight. Chris Christie also isn't doing well, especially for a candidate who has effectively staked his campaign on success in New Hampshire. The New Jersey governor tried seemingly every tactic to win over voters in the Granite State, but right now it looks like he won't even finish in the top five on the GOP side of the race. If Jeb Bush can maintain the narrow edge he presently holds over Marco Rubio, it will position him well for the upcoming primaries, particularly in South Carolina, where millions of dollars in ads have already aired. But he's still fighting for third with Ted Cruz in the polls. Bush's campaign hinged on a strong showing in New Hampshire, and he tried to offer reassurance tonight that he's still in the fight. This campaign is not dead. We're going on to South Carolina, Bush said tonight, but was cut off by the networks which switched over to Donald Trump, who stepped up to speak at a different location. Thank you, New Hampshire. A somber but clearly gratified Bernie Sanders said, addressing a crowd of thrilled supporters in a high school gymnasium in Concord, New Hampshire. His win, he said, had sent a message to the country, that the government of our great country belongs to all of the people, and not just a handful of wealthy campaign contributors and their super PACs. Sanders began with an allusion to his electability argument, saying his campaign inspired record turnout, the energy and the excitement that the Democratic Party will need to succeed in November. He also made a pitch for party unity. The acrimony between Sanders and Clinton in recent days has had some Democrats worrying that it will be hard to bring the party together behind the eventual nominee, whoever it is. We will need to come together in a few months and unite this party and this nation, because the right-wing Republicans we oppose must not be allowed to gain the presidency. Sanders spoke for nearly half an hour, hitting most of the policy themes of his regular stump speech. But it was hard to begrudge him for going long. There's a chance this moment will be the high point of his entire political career. That's not how Sanders sees it, of course. He closed with a look forward. Now it's on to Nevada, South Carolina, and beyond. Donald Trump enters to the Beatles revolution, which is some serious trolling. African-American voters are the key to Hillary Clinton's nomination bid, which may be why she twice referenced the water crisis in Flint, Michigan, in her concession speech. Conventional wisdom suggests that Bernie Sanders, the Vermont socialist who defeated Clinton in New Hampshire, can't make inroads among blacks and other minorities. I'm not so sure. Although middle-aged and elderly voters recall Bill Clinton's presidency and are old enough to appreciate Hillary Clinton's record, millennial minorities weren't old enough to vote when the Clintons left the White House. The exit poll tonight shows Sanders roughly splitting non-white voters in New Hampshire with Clinton, 49-50%. I'll be closely watching future election results to see how Clinton and Sanders compete for young minority voters. Continued inroads by Sanders into these voting blocks would cause Clinton problems. I want to say, I still love New Hampshire, and I always will, Hillary Clinton said as she congratulated Bernie Sanders and conceded a loss in front of cheering supporters. Now we take this campaign to the entire country. We're going to fight for every vote in every state. In one speech, she tried both to take up the issues that have propelled Sanders and highlight the ones she believes will resonate with the African American and Latino voters she is depending on to deliver victories in South Carolina, Nevada, and the bigger states to follow. People have every right to be angry, but they're also hungry. They're hungry for solutions, she said. Clinton cast herself as a fighter, with a riff on the women's rights or human rights line that she famously delivered in China 20 years ago. And she reminded voters that she's been knocked down before. I know I have some work to do, particularly with young people, she said. It's not whether you get knocked down. It's whether you get back up. 3 weeks ago I reported from a Kosich event, where his campaign manager, Beth Hansen, predicted a strong finish. Our surge in New Hampshire is less than 4 weeks away. Hansen says, to scattered applause from the group of several dozen clean-cut people in bow ties and long wool coats. I feel really good about our ground game, she adds. We don't rely on the public polls.